It's glorious, it's superb, and they call it Gloriosa superba. This is the flame lily. How's it, guys? I'm Gus, the African plant hunter. This is part two in my ongoing series about this remarkable, extraordinary medicinal plant, Gloriosa superba. Enjoy. So let's talk about the flame lily in Ayurvedic medicine. This is one of the seven upavishas in Ayurvedic medicine, which is upavishas are mildly poisonous. Personally, I think it's very poisonous, but I guess in Ayurvedic medicine there are a lot more poisonous ones. And it has a really, really wide range of uses, mostly associated with the tuber and the roots, but also the stem, the leaf, the flower, and the fruit. So because I don't remember them all off the top of my head, let me just refer to some literature and share this with you. I'm back. Treatment of wounds, so not surprising in terms of antibacterial properties. Gonorrhea, leprosy, hemorrhoids. So hemorrhoids, that's actually really interesting because that's in Ayurvedic medicine, but it's also found in Africa. So in Africa, what happens is you cut a slice of the tuber and you apply it topically to hemorrhoids and they will go away. That also happens with wound healing, by the way. So you got a cut or whatever, if you just apply topically. As I said, be careful because it is poisonous. Also in Ayurvedic medicine, there's a blend with babchi seeds, black cumin, and the purple fleabane, and it's made into a paste and it's applied externally for a whole range of skin ailments. Now, here's another similarity with traditional medicine in Africa. In Africa, the Zulu and the Ndebele, they use the tip of the leaf to make a little ointment that is applied to prevent acne and to treat outbreaks. I don't know what the pharmaceutical activity is there, but I've heard it from many, many, many people. Highly, highly recommended. From an Ayurvedic point of view, there's a lot of purgative, emetic. So when you've got something that's inside you that you need to get out, a little concoction made from this because it's poisonous will of course cause that to come out. So that's quite useful. But again, I'm really warning you not to try this at home. But that is how it's used in Ayurvedic medicine and again in traditional medicine in Africa. Another Ayurvedic one is from the roots. When this is really interesting, and I'd love to know to think this one through and to really understand. You make a paste from the roots and you smear it over the palms of your hands and your feet in childbirth to make childbirth easier. I don't know. There's a lot of traditional medicine that I don't understand the pharmaceutical activity. I just know people say it works, and generally when people say it works for them. Another Ayurvedic use for the leaves are used to treat asthma. So a leaf extract, it's mixed with sesame oil, I think just as a carrier oil, and then it's used to treat asthma. So that's in Ayurvedic medicine. I've not heard of that in Africa, but I wouldn't be at all surprised given how widespread this plant is and the full range of applications that it's got. So that's just a little look at the Ayurvedic use of Gloriosa superba. I'm Gus, the African plant hunter, and I will be back with more on this astonishing plant very soon. All right, bye. Thank you for watching that, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. My name's Gus, the African plant hunter, if we haven't met before, and what I'm doing here is a little journey through African medicinal plants. I'm from Zimbabwe, in Southern Africa, and I've spent my whole life working with medicinal plants, and I like to share some of that with other people. So if you enjoyed that and if you'd like to see more, I've got a YouTube channel, African Plant Hunter. You'll find me there, Facebook, Instagram, etc., etc. So thanks for coming, thanks for watching, and I hope to catch you again. All right, take it easy. Bye.